Henry, does fighting at the Forum ever get boring?
Hell no. I love this place.
Is there any more pressure on a fight week being at home? Like, do you have people coming out of the woodwork for tickets and stuff like that?
That wouldn't be pressure. That would just be annoying. But, no, it's pretty cool.
Right on. So, the last time you fought was at the Forum, and you had one of your most memorable moments of your career when you knocked out Aaron Pico. It's a little surprising that it's taken from that moment in January all the way to September to see you fight again with the momentum that you have. Can you walk us through what you've been up to the last 7-8 months?
Yeah, it's been 7 or 8 months. Training, you know, mastering my craft and just trying to get better.
Did you get offered any fights in between, or
No? I was ready to go, and they're like, oh, just wait a couple more months. We're going to do this tournament thing. And I was like, fuck, all right, that's cool.
So what was your response when they came to you with the idea for the tournament? Were you all in on this, or what'd you think?
Well, I got pretty excited because I thought it was all going to be in one night. Oh. I was like, oh, hell yeah, dude, we're going to see who the fucking man is, huh? All right, let's fucking dance. But they're like, oh, it's going to be spread out. And I was like, oh, okay, cool. So, yeah.
Is that something, like, I'm assuming you must be, like, a fan of, the old Pride tournaments and UFC tournaments and stuff like that if you want to compete in something like that?
Yeah, that's some sick shit. I would love to be involved in that.
So, let's bring this over to your fight on Saturday night. Darian Caldwell, what's he bring? Is it as simple as stopping his wrestling, or is there more to that? Like what do you think are his streaks? What do you think are his strengths or his weaknesses, or what do you feel comfortable sharing here?
I don't know, dude. I'm not that smart, but it's pretty obvious what his strengths are. The dude's an elite level wrestler with some serious credentials that cannot be overlooked. And long, rangy, southpaw, and yeah, it is what it is, dude.
Is there any, the fact that he's coming up from bantamweight, is there any, do you feel any extra incentive to just, you know, not in my house type of thing?
Not so much, because he's fucking big. He's bantamweight, but fuck, I just gave him a big old hug right now, and he's like an inch taller than me, so I don't think the size is going to be an issue.
So you guys, I mean, he can be, he can pop off a little bit sometime, but it sounds like friendly enough going into this.
Ah, he's cool, dude, yeah.
Right on. So after the after Saturday night's fights, they're going to have the drawing that kind of, you know, if you get the right number, you might be able to determine what your kind of next fate is. Do you go for the title shot right away? Have you thought this stuff through?
Yeah, well, it's probably the easier question you could ask me. And, yeah, you definitely want to fight the champ, dude, whoever that is.
Whoever wins the title fight, you think if you have the opportunity, you want them next?
Yeah, for sure.
Did you watch the first half of the bracket? Did you see those fights?
I haven't, dude. I'm slacking. I got you, though.
Are you just someone who doesn't watch the fights unless you're on the card?
No, I watch fights for sure, but that opportunity didn't come. You know, I have a TV at my house, but it's never really on, and there's no cable or nothing, so... Yeah, I would have had to go out of my way to watch it, and I was in camp, so I'm like, nah. When you're in camp, dude, going out of your way for any little thing, you're like, nah, fuck that. I'm not doing that. So
you win the tournament. What do you do with the $1 million?
Again, dude, I don't know exactly what I'm going to do, but one thing for sure is I'm going to spend it all.
All of it?
Dude, that's what you do with money. It's going to be gone, dude. But hopefully it's going to be, like, spread out. I'm going to be smart about it. You know, I got some cool people in my life that I respect and that are pretty smart. So they'll keep me in line